Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to talk about how to set up cloth physics using the Auto Setup tool for Unreal Engine 5. If you're using the latest version of Auto Setup, cloth physics will perform great already, but this tutorial is just to show you some of the tweaks you can make to get the best results for your specific clothing. If you haven't yet installed the latest Auto Setup tool for Unreal Engine 5, then please check out the basic tutorial first. Okay, let's start off by exporting our character from Character Creator 4 in FBX format. In the settings, it's recommended that you select Delete Hidden Faces. The reason for this is that it can help to avoid issues where the mesh of your character's body may poke out from underneath the clothing in certain scenarios. Once you've imported your FBX into Unreal, you'll find a physics asset in your imported folder. If you open it up, you'll find that the collision shapes have already been set up. If you encounter any conflicts with the soft cloth and your character's skin mesh, this is the first place you'll want to look. We also have a separate tutorial that deals specifically with the hair physics as well. Let's explore the collision shape settings a bit. In this case here, you'll see that initially there is an issue with the drape of the character's skirt, which is caused by conflict with the collision shapes. What I'm going to do first is delete the unused collision shapes, which in this case are the upper and lower arms. After that, I'm going to adjust both the size and position of the collision shapes in the thighs and buttocks so that there is less interference with the natural drape of the shirt. When doing this, you can enable mirror mode to get perfect symmetry on both sides. Once I finish that and re-simulate, you'll see that the drape of the skirt is much improved, with less of the fabric catching on the leg collision shapes. Another way that you can refine your physics results in Unreal is by using cloth paint to customize your weight map. Although your weight map will import flawlessly from CC4 using the Auto Setup tool, there are still disparities between the physics engines in CC4 and UE5 that may cause some issues. After enabling cloth paint mode, I'm going to start by selecting the knee length clothing data item. Ensuring that the paint value is 100, I'll then begin to paint along the skirt, starting from the bottom. Any area of the skirt that is white will have a strong physics effect, so we want to ensure that the part of the skirt that would naturally drape and swish around with movement is completely white. Here I'm going a bit high, which is okay, because we're going to use the smooth feature to create a transition area. Once I've got decent coverage, I'll then move on to the smooth tool and click smooth mesh multiple times to get a decent gradient in the weight map for a smoother result. Once I'm satisfied, then I'll exit cloth paint mode, which will then bake the weight map. The results could still use some tweaking, so let's check out our cloth config settings. One thing we can try here is to lower the collision thickness in order to slightly reduce the effective range of our collision shapes. Also, under simulation, a higher subdivision count value can also help to reduce wrinkles upon simulation. A higher iteration count value allows more time to calculate a more accurate simulation, which often leads to better results as well. Please be aware that these two parameters will increase the stiffness of the constraints and generate better results, but they will also require more CPU cost, which can slow things down in certain scenarios if you're already using a large percentage of CPU processing. You may notice on the hip that there is a bit of an uneven mesh sticking out though. Let's enter into cloth paint mode again, and this time use the Cull Backface option to ignore the backface of this mesh's map. I'll then continue to paint around the hip area from all angles, focusing only on the front faces for smoothing this time. It will bake again, and now you'll see the simulation is improved. Let's see if we can't fine-tune things just a bit more using the techniques we've learned so far. I can move my hip collision shapes in a bit to allow for better draping of the skirt, and then also add in a new collision shape for the pelvis and scale that down. It can work in combination with the hip collision shapes for a more natural result. You can see the result is pretty decent now, but the physics effect is way too strong. One way to fix this is to decrease the iteration count value. After I do that, you'll see the result is much better. That's about it for this tutorial, guys. Just a couple of quick tips for refining your physics results for your CC4 character clothing in Unreal Engine 5. With the new Auto Setup update, the results will be great already, but you can always tweak them. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.